Hello, my name is Marco Davila. I'm a physician scientist, an associate member in the Department of Blood and Marrow Transplantation and Cellular Immunotherapy at the Moffitt Cancer Center and Research Institute in Tampa, Florida. Today, I'm going to be speaking about research that came from my laboratory in collaboration with the laboratory of Dr. Brian Betts at the University of Minnesota. The purpose of our research was to develop a novel therapy for graft-versus-host disease. Graft-versus-host disease is one of the most common and potentially deadly complications of allogeneic stem cell transplantations or bone marrow transplantations. Bone marrow transplantations are potentially curative therapies for patients with acute myeloid leukemia. The T cells derived from the bone marrow transplantation recognize the patient's leukemia as foreign and lead to a graft-versus-leukemia effect. However, sometimes these same T cells can also recognize the host tissue as foreign and lead to graft-versus-host disease. The mainstay of therapy for graft-versus-host disease includes calcineurin neuron inhibitors, which unfortunately, while able to mitigate graft-versus-host disease, also can reduce the potential for graft-versus-leukemia. So we wanted to determine if we could develop a targeted therapy for GVHD that did not worsen the graft-versus-leukemia effect. And we did that through the development of a chimeric antigen receptor. Prior studies had demonstrated that targeting CD83 with an antibody could prevent GVHD in mice. We wanted to see if a chimeric antigen receptor, or CAR, could mediate the same effect and potentially even better. So a CAR is simply a chimeric protein that's composed of an antigen binding moiety fused to the signaling elements associated with a T cell receptor. So we designed a second generation CAR, which means it also includes a co-stimulatory domain as part of the signaling elements, to include an anti-CD83 binding domain with a 4-1BB co-stimulatory domain and a CD3 zeta activation domain. We demonstrated that T cells genetically modified with this anti-CD83 CAR recognized or were genetically retargeted to the CD83. And this was able to mediate antigen-specific cytotoxicity, cytokine production, and proliferation.
Hi, I'm Brian Betts, a bone marrow transplanter and physician scientist at the University of Minnesota. As Dr. Davila was describing, yes, graft-versus-host disease remains a significant cause of transplant-related mortality. If we look at graft-versus-host disease prophylaxis today, it typically includes broadly acting calcineurin inhibitors. So this is usually tacrolimus plus some other medication, including methotrexate, mycophenolate mofetil, or even mTOR inhibitors like sirolimus. And tacrolimus is still incorporated in state-of-the-art strategies to prevent graft-versus-host disease, like post-transplant cyclophosphamide. So what's the problem with calcineurin inhibitors? Well, for one, they limit long-term immune tolerance and even freedom from immune suppression post-transplant. And this occurs because calcineurin inhibitors impact both the number and functional potency of immune suppressive regulatory T cells, or Tregs. And secondly, calcineurin inhibitors limit beneficial graft versus leukemia by reducing the activity of key effectors of GVL, like cytotoxic T lymphocytes and natural killer cells. Acute myeloid leukemia, or AML, is the main indication for allogeneic hematopoietic cell transplantation today. The 3-year overall survival remains about 50%, so clearly we have work to do to improve outcomes. Relapse alone accounts for 50 to 60% of deaths post-transplant, and severe graft-versus-host disease contributes another 16%. So that poses a very important question. Can we develop a strategy that not only prevents graft-versus-host disease, but also concurrently reduces AML relapse?
So using a NSG mouse model that are implanted with 25 million human PBMCs, we're able to demonstrate that these mice developed graft-versus-host disease quite rapidly, ended up dying from weeks to months after injection. When we injected, when we co-injected control T cells at the same time, we were able to see no impact on preventing GVHD. However, when we co-injected anti-CD83 CAR T cells at both a high dose, 10 million, and a low dose, 1 million, we were able to see that the mice were able to survive from graft-versus-host disease, and we could see improvement in terms of clinical GVHD scoring, and the pathological tissues were demonstrated significant improvement in terms of tissue infiltration. So that was prevention of GVHD. We also wanted to see if these anti-human CD3 CAR T cells could actually treat GVHD, because we anticipate as a cellular therapy that this will not be required for all patients, since all patients don't necessarily develop GVHD. So we wanted to see if it could actually treat GVHD. To do this, we modified this previous animal model. Instead of co-injecting the CD3 CAR T cells on the same day where we co-injected the 25 million PBMCs, we injected the CAR T cells 2 weeks afterwards. This time point was chosen because the mice were demonstrating already evidence of clinical GVHD at this time, and we sacrificed some mice. We can see clear infiltration of some of these tissues with T cells as well. So when we injected the anti-CD3 CAR T cells at day 14, we could see the mice rapidly improved, resolved their clinical GVHD status, and the mice ended up surviving significantly compared to groups treated with controlled T cells. So this was able to demonstrate prevention and treatment of graft-versus-host disease. When we looked at potential mechanisms for this ability to treat and prevent GVHD, we looked at upregulation of CD3 within various compartments. Antibody studies supported a model where the antibody was targeting CD3 on dendritic cells. We were able to evaluate this as well, and we saw little to modest benefit by targeting dendritic cells with the CD3 CAR. We believe it's more likely due to targeting CD3 on CD4 T conventional cells, which are believed to be the critical cell subset for initiating and maintaining graft-versus-host disease. We were able to demonstrate that these CD4 positive CD3 T cells are killed by the CD3 CAR T cells, and the ratio of regulatory T cells, which help prevent or minimize graft-versus-host disease, to T conventional cells was maximized to almost a 300-to-1 ratio, which we believe played a major role in being able to prevent and treat GVHD. So with this evidence, we believe we're able to start evaluating the safety of CD3 as a target with the CAR T cell. However, we don't believe that a phase 1 first-in-human trial for patients with steroid refractory GVHD would be the optimal patient population. So we looked for expression of CD3 on malignancies, considering that CD3 has been noted to be upregulated on some hematologic malignancies. We're able to demonstrate by sampling patients' bone marrow treated here at the Moffitt Cancer Center, identify significant upregulation of CD3 and quite frequent expression of CD3 on the blasts of these patients' bone marrow. So this suggests that AML could also be a target of CD3 CAR T cells. So we did an in vivo animal model where we implanted a xenograft of AML cells into mice and treated them with CD3 CAR T cells or control CAR T cells. And we were able to see a significant improvement in survival from leukemia in these mice, which suggests that CD3 CAR T cells can be both a therapy for graft-versus-host disease as well as acute myeloid leukemia.
If we look at the illustrative abstract to the left, we see what happens when our CAR T cell is not present. CD3 positive alloreactive conventional T cells can cause damage to host tissues. And typical graft-versus-host disease target organs are the liver, skin, and gastrointestinal tract. Now down below, we see what happens when our CAR T cell is present. It's not only able to destroy CD3 positive alloreactive T cells, but also CD3 positive AML blasts. So in summary, within our manuscript, we show that CD3 is expressed on pathogenic alloreactive CD4 positive T cells, including Th1 effectors, as well as AML blasts. We show there's low to no CD3 expression on tolerogenic Tregs, cytotoxic CD8 positive T cells, and hematopoietic stem cells. And importantly, we show that antiviral immunity remains intact in the presence of these CD3 CAR T cells as well. So in effect, we have a strategy to prevent the two main causes of death post-transplant, graft-versus-host disease and AML relapse.
We are now working towards translating this therapy into a phase 1 clinical trial at our institutions. Thank you.